Here is the next free installment for the Free Active Directory course. In this video, I will look at upgrading your Active Directory environment to one that can run Windows Server 2008 or Windows Server 2008 R2 domain controllers. You need to meet a few prerequisites before you can start adding a Windows Server 2008 domain controller to your Active Directory environment. First, you need to ensure that you do not have any NT4 domain controllers on the network. If you do, they need to be upgraded or removed. For the rest of the domain controllers on your network, ensure that they are running Windows Server 2000 with Service Pack 4 or above. Second, you need to ensure all the domain functional levels in your forest are Windows 2000 native or higher. For information on how to do this, please see our previous video on domain functional levels. Third, you need to ensure that your forest functional level is set to Windows Server 2000 or higher. Once again, see our previous video on forest functional levels on how to achieve this. Finally, make sure that you are a member of the Schema, Enterprise, and Domain Administrators groups. In large organizations, this may not be possible, and you may need to have someone in these groups perform some of the steps required. Once you meet these prerequisites, you are ready to start preparing your environment for your first Windows Server 2008 domain controller. To prepare your Active Directory environment for your first Windows Server 2008 domain controller, you need to run a tool called AD Prep. This is located on the Windows Server 2008 DVD in the Support directory. This will prepare your forest and your domain for Windows Server 2008. If you are installing your first Windows Server 2008 R2 domain controller in an environment with Windows Server 2008 domain controllers, you only need to perform the first two steps below. This is because the Windows Server 2008 R2 DVD contains additional changes that are not on the Windows Server 2008 DVD. If you are not planning to install R2 domain controllers, only Windows Server 2008 domain controllers, I would still use the copy of AD Prep found on the R2 DVD if you have it. This will make your environment ready for the R2 domain controllers when you decide to deploy them. It is safe to do this as AD Prep only expands and prepares your environment for new features. It does not affect the way your current environment will run. It is not uncommon in large environments for these changes to be made months before the first 2008 domain controller is deployed. First of all, you need to run adprep/forestprep. This will make changes to the schema to make it ready for new features. Since it changes the schema, it needs to be run on the domain controller that is holding the Schema Operational Master role. In a large environment where you are responsible for a child domain, you may need to contact someone in the Enterprise Administrators group to run this step on your behalf. Once done, allow some time for Active Directory replication to occur or force a replication. Later in the course, I will cover Active Directory replication, so don't worry if you don't know how to do this yet. The next step is to run the command adprep/domainprep. This needs to be run in every domain that you are planning to deploy Windows Server 2008 domain controllers in. This command needs to run on the domain controller that is holding the Infrastructure Operational Master role. AD Prep expands Active Directory to make it ready for new features. If you run the AD Prep command a second or even third time, this will not affect your current environment. If you are not sure, run the command again. These steps make changes to the Active Directory environment in order to get it ready for new features. They do not affect the running of your current environment. You could make the changes and not add any Windows Server 2008 domain controllers for months or even years. The next command is the same as the last, but adds the /gpprep. This command prepares the domain to run a feature called Resultant Set of Policy Planning Mode, amongst other things. The next command is optional. If you are planning to deploy read-only domain controllers, a topic I will cover in a lot of detail in later videos, you need to run adprep/rodcprep. If you are not planning on deploying any read-only domain controllers, you can skip this step. In my opinion, it does not hurt to run the command even if you are currently not planning to deploy any read-only domain controllers. If you change your mind later on, Active Directory will be ready. I will now change to my Windows Server 2003 domain controller to demonstrate how to upgrade it to Windows Server 2008 R2. First of all, I need to check that the forest level is set high enough to support the upgrade. To do this, open Active Directory Domains and Trusts from the Administrative Tools under the Start menu. Then right-click the domain and select Raise Forest Functional Level. In this case, the forest functional level is set to Windows Server 2000 Native, which is the lowest forest functional level to which it can be set in order to make your forest server 2008 ready. If you do need to raise the forest functional level, it is a good idea to give the forest some time to replicate the changes before performing the next steps. If I exit out of Active Directory and Trusts, I next need to check if this domain controller is holding the Schema Operational Master role. To do this, first install the Schema Snap-in by running the command regsvr32schmmgmt.dll. Once installed, run MMC from the Start menu and then add the Active Directory Schema Snap-in. Right-click Active Directory Schema and select Operations Master. As shown, the Schema Operational Master role is held by the domain controller that I am currently on. I can now exit the Schema Snap-in and open a command prompt from the Start menu to run the ADPrep tool. The ADPrep tool is found in the ADPrep folder under the Support directory. To prepare the forest, I will run the command adprep/forestprep. When I run the command, I will be given a message informing me that all domain controllers need to be Windows 2000 with Service Pack 4 or above. When you are ready to proceed, press C and then Enter. Changes will now be made to the Active Directory forest to prepare it for Windows Server 2008 domain controllers. The process on this server takes just under 5 minutes, so I will pause the video and return shortly. Now that the changes to the forest have been made, I am ready to make changes to the domain. Before performing the next step, you should allow some time for the changes to replicate around your network, particularly on large networks with a lot of domains. Before running the next command, I will check the domain functional level by opening Active Directory Users and Computers from Administrative Tools under the Start menu. Then right-click the domain and select Raise Domain Functional Level. Here you can see the domain functional level is Windows 2000 Mixed. In order to proceed, I need to raise the domain functional level to Windows 2000 Native. This is done by simply pressing the Raise button. Windows will give you a message about the process not being able to be reversed, and also will remind you to allow time for the changes to replicate throughout the domain. Now that I meet the minimum domain functional level requirements, I can return to my command prompt and run the command adprep/domainprep. The process on this server took a couple of seconds. Windows will give you a message telling you to run the gpprep command as well to update some of the security settings. This command is required to run on the domain controller that is holding the operational master role. To check that you are on the correct server, go back to Active Directory Users and Computers, right-click your domain, and select the option Operations Masters. From here, select the tab Infrastructure. Here you can see the domain controller that has the Infrastructure Operational Master role. This is the domain controller that I am currently using, so I can continue with the next command. If I now exit Active Directory Users and Computers, I can now run the command adprep /domainprep/gpprep. The process did not take long to run on this domain controller. On a heavily utilized network, the process may take longer. The last command you only have to run if you are planning on deploying a read-only domain controller. The command is simply adprep/rodcprep. The process, once again, did not take too long to run. That's it. Your Active Directory environment is now Windows Server 2008 domain controller ready. You can either add a new Windows Server 2008 domain controller to the network or upgrade an existing domain controller to Windows Server 2008. Either way, Active Directory is now ready. One point I would like to add is these steps are only required if you want to add Windows Server 2008 domain controllers to your network. There is nothing stopping you from adding a computer running Windows Server 2008 to your network as a member server without performing any of these steps. A member server is simply a server that is added to the domain that is not a domain controller. So you could, without performing these steps, add a new Windows Server 2008 application server, DHCP, or DNS server without issue. In the next video, I will look at adding a child domain to the Active Directory forest. Active Directory can scale easily to millions of objects, but in some cases, you may need to configure child domains. I hope you've enjoyed these free videos from IT Free Training. For more free videos, please feel free to subscribe to us on YouTube or be alerted to new videos on Facebook or Twitter. Thanks for watching.